Hello, my name is Arzina Jaffer, and today I'll be presenting my project entitled Tissue Resident Fibroblasts Exacerbate Local Inflammation During Fibrotic Skin Wound Healing. Over time, as mammals evolve, this idea of tissue regeneration has been selected against for in favor of a more rapid response. And although this rapid response is very effective in preventing infection, it results in scar formation and ultimately impaired tissue function. The mechanisms that result in scar formation or tissue regeneration are very poorly understood due to a scarcity of animal models. However, recent work in the Bernaski lab has identified the reindeer as a very powerful model of regeneration, because if you create an injury on the back skin of the reindeer, it forms a scar, but if you create an injury on the velvet skin of the reindeer, which is the skin on the antlers of the reindeer, it regenerates. So we surmise that these differences in wound healing outcomes is because of the presence of fibroblasts and their interactions with endothelial and immune cells. So in order to test this hypothesis, we performed single cell RNA sequencing on the velvet and back skin of the reindeer at day 0, 3, 7, and 14 post-excision injury. Single cell RNA sequencing is a technique used to understand and to identify the transcriptional profiles of thousands of cells at a single cell resolution. So once we conducted these experiments, we then had data in which we could bioinformatically analyze to answer our questions. So the first thing that we did was look at the day zero samples, because perhaps there was something present in the back skin or the velvet skin that was already in the uninjured skin that preferentially primes it to either regenerate or to form a scar. And this is what we found. So if you look at these UMAP projections, every single dot represents a single cell. And as you can see in the back, there are a far greater number of fibroblasts present in the back in comparison to the antler. We then performed a correlation analysis, which looks at the gene profiles between back and velvet and essentially tells you how similar that cell type is between the back and velvet. And what we found was that the fibroblasts, again, were different between the back skin, were one of the most different cell type between the back and the velvet skin. So then we further analyzed the fibroblasts and identified three distinct populations of fibroblasts: profibrotic, pro-regenerative, and then mixed. So now that we know that at the day zero time point, the fibroblasts are distinct, what does that mean for the immune response? So then we analyzed the days 0, 3, 7, and 14 immune cells. And what we can see is that there are differences between the immune response, because not only is there a delayed immune response in the velvet, which is shown by a fewer number of cells at the day three time point, but also it's a shortened immune response, which is shown by the depletion of immune cells at the day 14 time point. But not only is the immune response distinct between the back and velvet, but also the immune cells that are present in that immune response are different, because there is a 1.45-fold higher and 1.6-fold higher of these CD68 NOS-positive macrophages in the back compared to the velvet. And these macrophages are usually involved in leukocyte extravasation and vasodilation. But also you see an enrichment, a tenfold enrichment of these CD68 CSF1 positive myeloid cells present in the velvet compared to the back, which are more of an immunosuppressive type of immune cell. So now that we know that at the day zero time point, the fibroblasts are different and the subsequent immune response is different, how do those two interact? And to understand this, we performed a connectome analysis, which shows the interactions between different cell types. So at the day zero time point, the fibroblasts, which are in red, interact more with these myeloid cells and these macrophages, which are immune cells, compared to the velvet, where the fibroblasts interact more with the endothelial and the VSM cells. So it's perhaps these differences in fibroblasts that result in these differences in interactions, ultimately the differences in the immune response and the differences in the wound healing outcomes. So either regeneration or scar formation. Ultimately, together, our findings show that fibroblasts are active and potentially targetable orchestrators of inflammation, in which we could attempt to create novel therapeutics that could improve wound healing and ultimately benefit the lives of millions of individuals around the world. So I'd like to finally thank these funding organizations, specifically Calgary Firefighters and NSERC, and I'd like to thank you for listening to my presentation.